Friends, it's indeed a matter of great honor to have with us Ms. Pankajam Sridevi, Managing Director, Commonwealth Bank of Australia in India. She's in fact our guest of honor. Pankajam Sridevi is the Managing Director of Commonwealth Bank of Australia in India. She carries a rich experience in diverse segments ranging from manufacturing to technology to banking domains. She is passionate about building a learning and innovative organization through continual improvement and transformation where employees build their careers and provide exemplary customer service. Another passion of hers is to build an inclusive organization with equal opportunities to men, women, persons with disability, as well as to LGBT persons. I invite up here on stage to deliver the keynote address, Reimagining GBS Leadership to Outperform.
So, good morning.
Good morning.
Come on, we need more energy. Good morning.
Good morning.
That's it. That's how shares of this forum should act. I have beautiful slides. I'm just digging you, Ravi. So I have beautiful slides, but it's not getting projected. But I must tell you, as shared services leaders, we must manage any eventuality, you know. See that? So I want to thank Nirvan from my team. He really helped me to put up this pack very, very quickly. So what I'm going to talk is on GBS leadership. When Ravi said I have to come and give a talk to you, I was like, what is he going to give me? And when he gave the topic on outperformance in leadership, I was quite happy because that's a topic that's so important today and it will remain important for many years to come. So, is it reflecting here? So it's gone. So I know that when you see this environment is changing, you have seen this many, 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 many times. But why I put this is for to set the context and give the four paradigms of how the environment is shifting. One of them is surely, I want to start with customer. The customer's awareness on what they can get from us, from any industry, is changing drastically. Thanks to whatever we call as big data, even though it's not big, but it is because customers have more choices and they have lot of awareness. Lot of awareness on what they want. They are looking at exemplary service. They don't want to put in any effort to get their service. So it's a huge shift in the customer's mind space. What about the market? The market is changing drastically because we can see that the middle class, which is very, very important, that group is really making decisions on what they want from customers. So the emerging market is very, very different to what we have seen. And of course, we spoke a lot about technology, and I completely agree with you that people come first. So I always say people, process, technology in that order. But technology is disrupting. It is disrupting big time, and the beauty is that it is getting very cheap. So today, technology is not as expensive as what it used to be earlier. So that's a huge disruption. And how does it match with what the customers want? And that's a huge thing that is happening in the market today. And the most important aspect is that the expectation of our employees is changing drastically. So employees, they want work-life balance. Surely they don't want the command and control culture, which is very much predominant in all leaders. All of us like that, but employees do not want that. They want real empowerment. They want to look at things very, very differently. Now, in these four changing environments, what does it mean about leadership? God, this is also gone. Okay. So, before I just get into leadership, I thought that I'll give a little bit of focus on what is it to be a strategic asset for any organization. And I think Ravi touched upon it in many areas. But I think how we really create what we want with our principles is in three factors. One of them is creating awareness. Because many a time, really speaking, see, Ravi just gave a mention saying that one person, one very senior leader that we discussed with, did not even reach out to us in India. So how do we create awareness of what we can do for organizations? And when we are very good at it, automatically there will be interest. What is the doubt? Because we have so much of capability and capacity and talent that is available in India. How do we convert that awareness to interest? And how do we convert interest into adoption? Sorry, I just missed that word. So it's awareness, interest, and adoption. So if you look at how organizations are really managed, it is support an organization. If I categorize into segments of work that we do for any parent organization, it is really support the organization. So all the telephonic kind of support, etc., come under that, or even technology service management. Then it is run the organization. Most of the BPOs are really in that segment of saying, how do we run the organization? The third segment is change the organization. How do we really influence and change the organization? And fourth is transform the organization. So if you look at how any organization starts with a global in-house center or a global capability center or global business services, it's all really run and support. And that's because they are doubtful starters. We can have 1,500 GICs or GBS in India. The 1,501 will go through the same cycle. You know, it's very unfortunate, but honestly, they go through the same cycle for two reasons. The number one reason is they're really worried whether we will impact the customer service. So we have to again and again build trust as number one initiative to really get growth. And that is by doing run and doing support very, very effectively. But can we remain doing run and support? No. We have to really take effort to create interest as well as adoption into the change area. And how do we do that? So we start with run and support, but every interaction that we get, every opportunity that we get to speak to the parent organization, we create interest. It's not only me who leads the organization, it's every leader. Everybody in a GPS is a leader. At least you're leading yourself, isn't it? So you create interest. We continuously create interest, and we get to a strategic asset. When we move, we continue to run and we continue to support, but we move tremendously towards change and transformation. When we move there, actually the model we should think of, which is there very much in my mind, is can we get an aggregator to do the run and support for us? Many organizations may not be ready to do that in the beginning, but I think our goal is to say that we want to do the core. Can we get other aggregators to do the run and support for us? If we do not do that, if we don't think of that in the beginning, what will really happen is we'll continue to do run and support because we are very, very good at that. We get a lot of patting on our back and we just get complacent. This is the absolute truth because it's happened to me. So I can tell very strongly that unless we focus a lot on change and transformation, because with eyes closed, we can say that that is the core of any organization. We don't need to say that how do we become a strategic asset by aligning to the strategy of the bank or strategy of any organization. To be honest, the strategy is to change. Because the world is very disruptive, we cannot be innovating. Innovation is incremental change already. 10 years back, we used to say that, you know, continual improvement going slow, or it is small steps is continual improvement, whereas innovation is something big. But today, continual improvement is what you have to do every day on the floor by the knowledge workers. Innovation is small steps of change. But surely, disruptive is what everybody is looking at. Therefore, if we don't build a team that really works on changing and transforming in every opportunity that we get, I think we will miss the game. So I want to go to the next slide. I'm a little sad that this is flashing, but it's okay. When I see a leader, very senior leader, I used to say, can you describe yourself in one word? So this is all what I got from different leaders describing themselves in one word. And one of them is the CEO of CBA who came to India. His name is Matt Comwin. He said he's very persistent. And I really liked it. And in 1 month's time, I really realized that truly he's persistent. Ravi, how do you describe yourself in one word?
Passionate.
What about Romy?
Creating other leaders.
Creating other leaders. So you can see that the minute you ask somebody that what is it that one word that describes you, they really go to the core of their capability. So you said passionate. He's passionate. You saw that. You saw in the first session. So that's core of a leader. So I really interviewed a lot of leaders and they said all these great words. And the CEO of the organization worked earlier said humility. So passionate, proactive, patient, and I like the best is cultivator. I think that's what you said in one word if you see it's building other leaders. So if you see the passion and the kind of agility that our leaders have, I'm talking of senior leaders who said this, this is the mind space that they are in. They are capable. We are all capable. There's no doubt about it. I'm very proud of the capability that we have. But then, are we focusing a lot on run and support? That's something that we have to really look at. And honestly, I don't have mantras, but I thought that I'll really talk on my experience on leadership. So you kind of stole the show a little bit, Ravi, by using my words. You know, yesterday I called him and told him. So it's like, you know, the core thing is you have to be very brave and stand up to cause. I can't see it actually, sorry. So take charge. So take charge is very important. But I think the next aspect is be in charge. Because many a times we take charge and then we get lost. And I think the mantra is, I just wanted to get it into three sectors. One of them is saying that lead the business. It's very, very important to lead the business because we have to set business context. I can give you an example. When I was working in the earlier bank that I was working, actually, the first thing that happens in a home loan is a customer who comes for home loan, we have to give a letter of offer. Saying that, yes, based on all the documents that we gave, we will give you 2 million. If you sit in India and think of the Indian context, that's not very important, guys. Because we'll just go and see a house and we'll say, yeah, we like it. Then we'll not go there at all. We'll go and see another house. We like it. Then we'll pay some advance and then buy that. That's the context in Indian industry. But it's very, very different in Australian industry. You have to go and stand in front of the house and there's a big auction. Can you believe it? A 3 million house, which is like 15 crores house, is sold on the road. I just couldn't believe it. I went there and I took a video. I just wanted to show the team the business context. It's a very different context to what it is in India. So I think as leaders, so the letter of offer is so critical in Australia for the customer because on the basis of that letter, they will give $10,000 as advance. And if you go away from that deal, you lose the money. So for the customer, that letter of offer is so critical when compared to the business context that we have. So I think when we lead others, the most important thing, no signal buddy, most important thing is to build the context. And also, you know, there's something else that is so very critical is showing grit. See, many leaders, we just say that, okay, I have to show grit. But how do you show it? It's not enough if you are brave. But I think it is through the agility that we have in learning. Should I stop or I continue? Please don't try to do that. Let me at least see my slides. Otherwise, you know. So when I say lead the business, it's managing complexity and ambiguity to our advantage. There is a lot of complexity, ambiguity, and that's when GBS comes into being as a strategic asset. If everything was clear, then it is for cost arbitrage. And in my mind, there's nothing wrong for cost arbitrage, because if you look at one definition of productivity, that's really cost. If you're selling a pencil at 1 rupee, if your cost price of a pencil is 1 rupee today, and you make it 90 paisa, then your productivity is 10%. There is no other formula for cost arbitrage, so nothing wrong in that. But I completely agree that that's something that you can only measure. So you have to control various other things to get there. But more important is to really take advantage of the ambiguity and bring clarity, because we know the business context. The other thing is, you know, the other big thing I think we touched upon, and I'm sure it will get touched upon the whole day, is sell our ecosystem with pride. There is no other country that has got 1,500 startups to really support on various technology and product and business innovations. So we can bring that disruption, but we must be listened to. So that's building the business context and leading the business. But there's something also saying lead yourself. Because if you're a really powerful leader, there are three concepts to it. One is, of course, leading the business. Second is leading yourself. And the very important aspect of leading yourself is, how relevant are you in the market? If we want to manage ambiguity, we have to be very, very relevant. And the bigger point is, are we really getting people who are better than us? If we have people who are better than us around us, then we are building global capability. And when you lead others, leading others is not by micromanaging and command and control, because the millennials of this age will not like it. They really want much more freedom, and we know that with our children, in our home itself, that's what happens. They want a lot of freedom, empower them, give them the opportunity to think. Let's not say that, you know, oh, I have seen this earlier in my life 20 years ago, and it will not work. So this is a standard statement that most of us make, which we have to avoid, and influence the principles. I want to tell you a story here. When I was in my earlier organization, I just could not get time with one of the leaders. Whenever I tried, the leader would, oh, I'm busy, that, this. So I found out a routine. I don't need to do that. I could have ignored that leader because I have too many other things to do. But it is going after detractors. So it's a very important aspect to go after detractors. And if we get an opportunity to convince and influence a detractor, then our internal power just increases. So that's the only reason why I went after her. And I told her that I want to tell you that a lot of things are aging in your organization. The Provident Fund release, which is a regulatory thing, superannuation, that's aging. Because I went and looked at her data, because I had to capture her attention. And she's, I know that. She said that, you know, even then she said that, I know that. And I said, yes, but you don't know one fact. And that fact is that 25% of this aging is more than 75 days. She was stunned, friends, for a second. That information she didn't know. And I think she immediately turned back. And I must tell you that next half day, she canceled all meetings to sit and discuss with me what is the problem. So why I tell this story is very important for us to solve problems for our parent organization. Everyone will look at somebody else in their group to solve their problem. And we are really problem solvers. And then we are moving from run and support towards change. And I just wanted to give some reflections. Some of them are a little controversial. So I want to say that we have to reflect on ourselves. Are we the change that we want to see in ourselves? Are we saying that let me live with what I have, and let me not challenge or look at what needs to be done? It's a very big question that we have to answer. Romy and me were having a discussion, and I was like, size matters, but even if we are 300, we can make a difference to the parent organization by standing up and saying these are the things that we do. But are we getting complacent as GBS leadership? Are we drawing these fat salaries, except me, of course? I mean, drawing flat salaries and saying that, let me continue in this job. Just live and let live. Are we doing that? If we are doing that, then we are not doing the right thing for the future. Are we getting equitable relationship in every interaction? I think this is very, very critical. Are we content by being doers? Are we saying that we will follow because I'm already in my comfort zone? Or are we striving for an equitable relationship? I think this is very, very critical. People call it a seat in the table, etc. But I know we discussed and said that's a jargon. But the point is that we need to be heard. We need to be acknowledged as a group of people who can make a difference to customer. And the customer angle must come very, very strongly because of the paradigm shift that is happening in the industry, and that is customers are more demanding. How do we attack that and say that what do we do with technology? What do we do with our people to really make a difference to the customer? Still it's going. And do we wait for things to come to us? I wait and wait and wait and wait for things to come to me, or am I proactive and sniff out problems, sniff out issues that need support? When I say problems, it can be anything. It can be something regulatory. It can be something, you know, which is so critical. It can be something with to do with what we did wrong with customers or employees. We have to sniff the problems. And it is not easy. It's not easy because our location is not the same. We are far away. But friends, we can know that you identify things through any small interactions with them. It's not that we cannot identify that. And the last one that I wanted to say is cultivate talent for bold moves. Are we really focused on building our talent? Are we leading a shadow? Because we leave a shadow. Are we leaving a shadow that is of a learning culture, of a learning organization? It's a very important point to ponder and say that, are we building a leadership that's better than what we are? If we have confidence, if the GBS leadership does not have the confidence on themselves, then I'm 150% sure that we will be building minions. There's a point for us to think of, are we building minions because we want it that way, or are we building stars because we want it that way? I want to say that our mantra in CBA is, so if you look at banking, straight through processing is a very, very important word. It means that customer is getting very good service. So our mantra is straight to Pankajam and team. What's your mantra? Thank you.